Hi, welcome to my channel. Well, 20 knives on the table. Actually, there are more knives on the table because part two is a knife sale. That was, I was intending to do this last week, but I forgot it in the excitement of streaming live. So, hope you will enjoy this episode. And if you have questions, please let me know. Let me check the comments first. I can't connect to the chat, I'm sorry. So I don't see any comments. Maybe it will... Let me see. No, I can't see any comments. So... Just let me start. It is a pity, by the way, because now I don't know if the sound is okay, if you can hear me, if the video is okay. I don't know what to do. Let me test. Let me write a comment myself. Well, I see it coming, but I'm sorry. Chat in a new display. Oh, I see comments in a new window. Okay, a lot of guys already joined me. Hi Joshua, hi Jeroen, hi Stefan, hi John, Voktucci, hi Dimitri. Okay, I hope the sound is good. Okay, John already told me the sound is good. Okay, let me start. First of all, I'm a knife collector, and I think you are all knife collectors. And of course, every knife collector has one or more Swiss Army knives in his collection. And this is a fun one. This is a Strelsen limited edition. Last year, I needed a new coat, and I was in the store for a new coat, and my daughter came with a Strelsen coat, and I fitted it on, and it was okay. It was a nice coat. It was the right size, and then I found within on the inside a little pocket with a Swiss Army knife, a Strelsen knife. I hope it shows well on the camera. So that was for me a sign that it was a coat I had to have. So let me change window. So a little Swiss Army knife by the brand Strelsen, specially made for the brand Strelsen, with toothpick, with so complete sack. So that's the first one. So I'm very happy to have this. Then second, I have some Spydecos on the table, some more older models. This is the Clipit Rescue. This is the Clipit Merlin. I think these are hard to find these days. FRN scales and ATS 55 blade steel. Backlock design, very light, and that's why they were built to be as light as possible and very smooth walk and talk. I always thought this was strange in the design, so the blade, the cutting edge was not entirely into the frame, but you can't cut yourself on it. Another one from the same series. This is the Clipit Pacific Salt with H1 steel. I think this was the first with H1 steel. A lot of the properties shared with the other Clipit models, designs, backlog. H1 steel, so rust, very rust resistant, serrated, very light, and very smooth walk and talk. The Clipit series is made in Japan. And then another one, this is the Rescue Junior. Actually, I have two on the table. I even, till today, I didn't know I had two. I don't know, sometimes I forget that I buy something, but these are very, very capable knives. ATS 55 steel, so a kind of 440C-ish. All very smooth walk and talk, all Japanese made. By the way, I have two, if someone is interested, let me know, shoot me a DM, and I'll give you a very nice price. So the Clipit series of Spyderco. I don't know if these are still in production. I think the Merlin is very difficult to find. But about the Rescue Junior, I really don't know. I'm not a real Spyderco fan. Though I have several Spyderco knives, I'm not really a fan. Oh, by the way, what I like about the Clipit series, and let me switch cameras, is the checkering on the FRM, and it really provides, I don't know if it shows, yeah, it really provides a lot of grip without creating hotspots. So it's a very, very nice texture. Really very nice. Okay, that's the Clipit series. Next, I have some Wii knives on the table. As you all probably know, I used to work for Wii till last year, August. Then we split up. And my very first Wii was also the very first Wii knife design under their own brand, Wii. Before that, Wii was only working as an OEM manufacturer. And this is the 601, so the first knife under their own brand. This is still a favorite of me, and I have two on the table. So this variety, and then the PVD black-coated variety, and all high specifications, F35 VN blade steel, full titanium frame, 6 ALV, ceramic bearings. And by the way, the first iterations were steel bearings, by the way. So I think these have steel bearings. And this was my very first. And Wii Knife, when they came to the market with this knife, they were nowhere to get in Europe. So I found out about these and I asked a dealer in the Netherlands who was visiting Blade Show to bring me one with him. And so in Blade Show 2016, this particular knife was brought to me from Blade Show. And of course, the grind was pretty spectacular for those days. I hope it shows good on camera. That was very special. No manufacturer did such a grind. Okay, so the Wii 601. Then another one from Wii Knife is the 602. This is one of my most favorite knives, and let me check the comments before I continue. Sound good, sound vitify. Hi Hank, hi Vasilius. Nice you are here as well. Hi Flores, you're late, but you joined in. Those have the hidden glass breaker, right? That is the Clipit. No, the Clipit doesn't have hidden glass breaker. I'm sorry. EDC knives, I'm doing very well. I hope you are doing very well as well. Hi, Don Bond. Nice you're being here as well. Okay, that were the comments. So the 602. This is one of my all-time favorites. A lot of people hate this design because of the keyholes, but I just love it. I used to carry the 602 a lot. I used it a lot. I really abused it. And then in, I think, 2018 or 2018, I was... I think it was in Atlanta, back from Blade Show to the Netherlands. or maybe important. I don't really recall it anymore. And I forgot to put it in my suitcase. So the officers on the airport had to confiscate my knife, and they destroyed it. So that was really, really very sad, but my own fault, of course. But the 602, I really like it. It's a very capable knife. I abused it. I used it for all kinds of tasks and course. I really didn't care if it had to cut through metal even, and it performed so good. Great action, of course. This one is with ceramic bearings, by the way. This is a later production run. And the 602, I really like it. By the way, the beads are made by a buddy of the Blazer brothers, Steven. He 3D printed these beads, and he made the lanyard as well with leather. So very nice. Yeah. Okay, next up, let me check the comments first. Jeroen, I think you're right. The large rescue probably had a hidden glass breaker. Tommy Gear, welcome. Okay, next up, that's this one. For many years, I follow Alan Elisiewicz, and I'm really a fan of his work. And this is the, let me change angle. This is the Alan Elisiewicz design produced by Eichhorn in Solingen. Eichhorn is a German manufacturer, and I think this is from the early 2000, I think 2006, 2007, this was produced, and it's a very nice mid-sized folding knife on the smaller side. Thumb studs, I forgot the steel, I think it was 440C, but or 8F34, and really very recognizable as Alan Elisiewicz. Great ergos, although it's a small knife, but great ergos, and you can really choke up this knife. So Alan Elisiewicz. Next up, this is a special one. This was the first folding knife made by a Dutch forum member, and he also visits our monthly meetings of the Blazer brothers. This is made by Willem Doorakker, and this is, was his first slip joint. And man, when you could feel this in your hand, the walk and talk, check the fit and finish, you really couldn't believe this was his first folding knife. This is a perfect made folding knife, slip joint, perfect walk and talk, very, very smooth. Everything fits perfectly centered, no blade play. Nice nail nick. Let me show it in this camera for a close-up. It really is very well made. So this is a special one. I bought this from him, I think, 3 years ago. He had it in his, he carried it with him to show. And I asked him if it was for sale. And I really like clip points. So I'm very happy I got this. Okay. Let me check some comments. I love the Wee knives. Yes, I love Wee knives as well. I have, I think, 150, 160 Wee knives. Jeroen, ah, thanks. In that case, there are so many smooths. There are sehr schön, große, wunderbar. Yeah. Yes, very nice. I think you refer to the Alan Elisiewicz, Stefan. It's a very nice size. Hank, you have very much experience with Chinese knives. Who is the best Chinese knife company? Vasilius, it's very hard to tell. I think the best Chinese manufacturer is Riyadh, but the most consistent Chinese factory is WeKnife. So I think they are almost on the same level. Not very much difference. That's my opinion. Is that the one by Willem? Yes, Jeroen, this is the one by Willem. Willem Doorakker. Dimitri, agree, Hank, Riyadh and WeKnife 100%. Yes. So Riyadh is really, for me, the best manufacturer because they do things before other manufacturers do them, and WeKnife is very consistent. So that's the difference. But with Riyadh, the consistency level is not on the same level as WeKnife. Okay, next up. Go ahead, if you have questions, just let me know. This is a very nice handmade knife, made by George Muller, South African knife maker. And George makes folding knives and fixed blades, a lot of hunting knives, and also a lot of traditional styled knives. He uses a lot of materials like gems, stone, woods, but also, how do you call it, G10 and that kind of stuff. And this one it has a very nice high polish blade. It has a very nice hollow grind, and instead of a nail lick, he has three small dimples, I call them dimples, on both sides, which make it very easy to deploy with your thumb. Instead of a nail lick, you use the dimples. It's a liner lock, and I forgot the material on the scales. I think it was a kind of wood with resin. It's a very nice fit of finish, but, and that's not something you might expect from George Muller, the blade, I don't know, I show it on the other camera, the blade tip, it's almost out of the frame, and you can cut yourself on this very small tip. I hope it shows. Yeah, here you can see it. Just maybe a tenth of a millimeter. So the quality control was not there when George shipped this knife, but this is an exception. Most of his work, actually all of his work, is of a very high level of quality. And this is an exception, but okay. George Muller, very nice knife, handmade. Next, this is also a handmade custom. This is a Jalamo, Pepe Jalamo made this. And he often makes traditional style knives. This one is made with stag. Stag. I don't know the steel, I forgot. It's a Warncliffe, and you can see the lines. And actually, this gives great ergos. It fits really very nice in the hand because of the upswept. And let me show it in this camera. Very well made, very good fit and finish. Bolster design, of course, and I think it needs about, well, around a kilo pressure to close it. Half stop, very good walk and talk, very nice, very well made. Next. This is a European made knife. This is made by Dagger. Dagger is a Russian manufacturer. And they make a lot of tactical knives. I hope the focus, yes, they make a lot of tactical knives. I don't know where these are produced. I don't know where these are produced, but it only says designed in Russia. So probably they are produced in China. This is a very tactical design. This is called the urban tactical. It's really meant also for reverse grip. It has a false edge. It's made with 440C steel liners. No milling inside the liners, so it's for the materials they used. It's not heavy, but on the heavier side, with G10. And well, you have to like the design, of course, but it's weird. It's different, and that was what attracted me, that it is different. Liner lock, very easy to deploy. No blade play, so very well made. Good fit and finish, but nothing more than that. So very affordable. I think they went around 70 euro or 60 euro, somewhere in that realm. So Dagger, Russian manufacturer. Let me check the comments first. Dimitri agree, Hank, yes, such a pity he doesn't make knives anymore. Willem made beautiful stuff. Yes, I agree with you, Jeroen, because Willem really makes nice stuff. He only made a few. Flo, there is a high-pitched noise every so often. Okay, let me know if it continues. I don't know what I can do about it. Wobtuki, Riyadh for consistent execution, but I have had an occasional problem with they were not willing to address nor fix. So for following through, I go with we. Okay. That's a pity, because I know David in person. I call him a friend. And that's funny. So I visited a lot of shows in the United States and in Europe. And whenever Riyadh was there as well, one of the evenings we went to dine together with the teams of the Chinese manufacturers, Riyadh as well. And David and me, most of the times, were the only two persons who smoked. So we smoked a lot of cigarettes outside of the restaurants. And I know that David is always willing to help his customers when there is a problem. So I wonder, with who did you have contact when you had a problem with your Riyadh knives? And what was the problem? Maybe you can let me know in the comments. Maybe I can shine another light on this. And Flo, is the Dagger also the one with a really cool case? No, the Dagger didn't come with a case. Yes, it has a nice case. Yes, you're right, Floris. It comes with a cool case. Yeah. Okay, next up. Wobtuki, David was the actual person who blew me off and would not address they had a problem with oil stained my carta that had bled through from the interior of the knife. Okay. Let me know what his answer was when you, what his actual answer was after the live stream. Okay, next up. I'm not really a huge fan of Boker, or Boker as we say, because the O has an umlaut, but there are sometimes they have a design I really like. This is one I really like. This is the 2003 anniversary knife, the decade knife. It was the first knife they introduced with the little shield on it. This shield, by the way. And it has a Damascus blade with the wooden scales, and it's really very nice. And over time, it develops a kind of patina on the Damascus, and I really like it very much. It's a liner lock, very smooth. Let me show it in this camera. It has a nice pattern on the wood. I hope it shows. There you can see the shield as well. And I really like this knife, as they call it, the 2003 Jahresmesser. So, knife of the year 2003. Next up, I started with the Victorinox. Every collector needs a Victorinox. And the same applies to Opinel, of course. Every collector needs at least one Opinel in his collection for at least one time. With the color lock. This is a variety called an oyster knife. So this is specially designed for opening oysters. Not much to tell about it, but Opinel really makes nice, affordable knives. Of course, not the best steel. The focus is, he's out of focus. Not the best steel, but very easy to sharpen. So, for beginning bushcrafters and so on, Opinel is really a nice brand. Next up, another Wee knife. This was their third design. In 2016 they started, and this was their third design, the 603. I hope it comes in focus. Yes. This was not a very popular design. It came in several color variations, but I really liked it very much. It's a big knife, frame lock design, great ergos. Let me pick this camera. Great ergos. Really great ergos, very smooth, ceramic bearings. It's really a sturdy, hard-use knife. Very good pocket clip. Half-open design with backspacer, all titanium hardware, ceramic bearings. So the 603. I don't think they are made anymore, because I think this was discontinued in 2018. But I really like mine. Next, another Wee. And this was for a long time the most popular model, the 604 or Dragon, I forgot the name, Dragon Scale. Tento design. I also have the limited edition with Demasteel. Big knife, long knife, 4-inch blade, ceramic bearings, F35 VM blade steel, came in several varieties, in several colors, and I really, this is one of my all-time favorites, the Dragon Scale, or 604. Yeah, one of the most popular Wii knife designs. Okay, let me check the comments. Hey, Ronald, welcome. Woptuki, David, Wop, 305. Tommy's gear looks similar to the Arbolito. I think you mean the Boker. Yeah, I think you mean the Boker, similar to the Arbolito. For the more money, you can't find anything better than an Opinel. You're right, Joshua. Except maybe Mora. Ronald, hey Hank. Hi Ronald, how are you doing? Jeroen Gerritsen, Death 603 was great. I remember my first introduction to Wii knives. I agree. The 604 is an integral, right? No, sorry, the 604 isn't an integral, but I can show it is. It looks like an integral because it doesn't have standoffs or a backspacer, but our two parts, frame parts, fit together. So it looks like an integral, but it isn't an integral. And you also have it. Yes, I have it on my arm as well. The 604. I hope it shows. Yes, the Boker. It does have similarities with the Arbolito. Joshua told me the 604 was still screwed from the 703 or 702. Don't know. They did. Yeah, the 701 was the first integral. The 701. That will come in one of the episodes also, because I think I have 150, 160 Wii knives. So that will come. Okay. Next up. This is also one of the most beautiful knives, production knives I own. This is, I think it was produced in 2015. Produced in China for a Russian company, custom knife factory. And this is the Sukhoi. It is a very long, slim, slender knife. I think this was made with F35 VM blade steel or maybe M390, I can check. With carbon fiber, titanium, ceramic bearings, titanium backspacer, titanium clip, carbon fiber, titanium, steel insert, very smooth, thumb stud opening, and very, very smooth. It drops. And this is one of the most beautiful knives, production knives I own. I just like the design. It's hard because of the angle to get my thumb in a natural way, but really it is very smooth. No blade play, perfectly centered. I like the Sukhoi very, very much. So, okay, let me check the comments. Sukhoi. Best CFK ever. CFK, CKF ever. Vasilius, I actually don't know who produces now these days for Custom Knife Factory, but there were always rumors that Kevin John produced the parts for Custom Knife Factory and they shipped it in parts. Now these days, I really don't know, but in the period of 2014, 2015, 2016, rumors told that Kevin John produced the parts and they shipped the parts to Russia and there they were hand assembled. But now these days, I really don't know. I think Kevin John still produces the parts for Custom Knife Factory. I'm pretty sure that they are not produced by Riyadh or Weknife. But I'm not, and some parts are produced in Russia. So, okay, I wouldn't be surprised if it's Riyadh. Well, for at least till 2019, I know pretty sure Riyadh never produced for Custom Knife Factory. I own a Sukhoi too. What a knife that it's all dialed in. Yes, I agree. Still available on the second-hand market where I found mine like nip, like new in box. I think you have to pay pretty well if you find a second, find one on the secondary market. There was also the Sukhoi 3, but I like the Sukhoi 2 better because of the color combination. But that's my personal preference, of course. Okay, next up. This is a little fixed blade. This is a Wanger Special. This is made Wanger Special. Wanger is Dirk Wanger from Messer & Co. in Germany. And Dirk has a web shop, a knife web shop. And for example, he was the first who introduced Enlan and San Renmu knives in Europe, but he also was the first introducing Wee knives and that kind of stuff. But he also makes special editions of existing designs for his own web shop. He was the first who introduced real steel in Europe. And this one is, this is a design by Heidi Blacksmith. Heidi Blacksmith is a German knife maker. And this was produced by Lion Steel for Dirk Wanger of Messer & Co. This is with olive wood. And I forgot the steel. Maybe it says something. Yes, Neolox steel. Comes with a very nice sheet. And it's really a very... very nice, EDC-able little fixed blade. I really like this one. I used to carry it a lot, but now these, the last year or so, or maybe last 2 years, I didn't carry it anymore because I have a lot of other knives I like to carry. And most of the time I carry a folding knife, but really it's a very, very nice, capable knife. I used it a lot. So the Heidi Blacksmith. And then the last is a fixed, also handmade hunting knife made by Gert van Es, a Dutch knife maker. And I have several of this style of his knives. I think I have 5 or 6. And Gert, his son, Peter van Es, is more known. And the funny story is, Gert followed the footsteps of his son. And you really can see similarities between the two in fit and finish. And that is to say, the fit and finish is of a very, very high level. They are both very perfection. I don't know how to say it in English, but it's almost perfect. I think this was made with 01 steel or 02 steel, and stabilized wood, birch wood, burl wood, and colored. And great ergos, comes with a nice leather sheet, and I really like this kind of knives. So this Gert van Es, a Dutch knife maker. It is a pity he is not very well known, and he doesn't make a lot of knives. I think he made 10 knives, and I think I own 5 or 6 of them. He also made a beautiful dagger, but pretty expensive. Daggers are very hard to make, of course, because of this. They have to be symmetrical on both sides. So you have 4 sides to be symmetrical, and it's very hard. So that was that were the 20 knives of my collection to be revealed this evening. Let me check the comments. Curious to I would be surprised. Yes, 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 yes. $400 on the Sukhai. Yes, too. I already thought so. It will be expensive. Originally, it was not far beyond that price. I think it was $350 or $375 originally, the Sukhoi 2. Very reliable dealer, in my opinion. Yes, Dirk Wanger, Messerund Co. is a very reliable dealer. I think I started ordering with Dirk in 2011 or 2012, so already 9 or 8 years ago. It's a very nice guy, very reliable. And if you have a problem with one of his orders, no questions asked. You can send it back in advance, he already ships the new stuff. So Dirk is really a very nice guy. Nylux is great stuff in my humble opinion. Yes, I agree with you, Jeroen. Stefan Heidi, yes, I also have a Heidi. What is your favorite blade steel, Hank? My favorite blade steel is very hard to tell, but it's not M390. I like the 440C-ish blade steels because they take a good polish. And a good polish means good protection. So like 440C, N690, ATS34, CPM 154, that kind of steels I like very much. And they are also very easy to sharpen, and they keep an edge for a good long time. So that kind of steels are my favorite steels. They are tough, and the super steels from now these days, or they aren't heat treated well, like M390, it really needs a very close window for heat treatment, between 61.5 and 62, 63. Below that, it will not keep an edge that very long. And heat treated in a higher Rockwell range, it will be very brittle. So that's why I like the 440C-ish steels. That's my opinion. RVL 34 is in the same range. So also CPM 154-ish steel, but then improved because it's a powdered version, of course. I got the Sukhoi 3. Big difference is the flipper. Yes, it's also a flipper, the Sukhoi 3. But I like the colors of this too. The Sukhoi, of course, is a very beautiful design, Richard. But I like the colors of the Sukhoi 2 better. But of course, a flipper is easier to deploy. RVL 34 is my current favorite steel. Well, it's it's for me, it's also a very good steel. I have a lot of knives with RWL 34 steel. I have a lot of handmade customs by Martin Annegarn, and Martin always uses RWL 34 steel. Have you tried Maximit steel? Till now, I don't own a knife with Maximit steel. I'm very curious about it, but till now, I don't own Maximit. Okay, next to part two. But first of all, if you didn't notice it already, I have a giveaway running on Instagram. Last weekend, I passed the 2,000 followers on Instagram, so I organized a giveaway, and I really have a very nice giveaway, I think, a $420 Leon Ma knives, Leon Ma design, the Endeavor. So check out my Instagram, give me a follow, like the giveaway post, and tag someone in the comment section, and you have a chance to win a $420 Leon Ma Endeavor. Okay, now the knife sale, as I promised to do last week, and I forgot. It are all prototypes. Prototypes from of Wii knives. And I have a lot of prototypes of Wii knife, and some I have more than one variation, so I thought it was time to clean up. So from the prototypes I have more than one, I can sell some. First of all, this is the prototype of the Wii knife Blocao, designed by Miguel Barbudo. It's a prototype with M390. Prototypes can differ a little bit from the final production knife, of course, but I don't think there is any difference with the production variety. This is with the window lock, and a very big, sturdy knife with Spanish influences. Let me take this camera because the focus on the other one is... The other camera focuses on my face, and knives are more beautiful. So the Wii knife Blocao. Then I have two of Wii knife Hecate prototypes designed by Alessandra De Santis. By the way, I was in person responsible for several of these prototypes for the collaborations with the knife makers. So I introduced Alessandra with Wii knife. I also introduced Miguel with Wii knife and a couple more that will come soon. So the Hecate is a very big, sturdy tactical knife. Alessandra is specialist in self-defense strategies and so on. She's also very well known in the firearm community in Italy, and she makes beautiful knives. So the Hecate, if someone is interested, he can pick the color of his choice, black or gray. Next up, I have a Mellus. I even have two prototypes with M390. By the way, these are also M390. All prototypes are in M390. The Mellus, the from the brothers Elliot, and I forgot the name. What's the name of the company? I forgot, sorry. So, if someone is interested in the Mellus, he can pick the color or the gray, the bronze one. And this one, I don't think the production varieties have a bronze anodized one, so this is unique. But the marbled variety is available as production, final production model as well. But with this one, you get something unique. But both are prototypes. Then the Arrakis. Elijah Hisham design. This is a prototype as well from the Arrakis. I have three of the same color variation. I already sold one. One will remain in my collection. So I have one still available for someone who is interested in the Arrakis. Great action. And this one is not, it is exactly the same as the production, final production variety. Then a German design, two folders, the Scopio and the Fixed, the Reazio. I also introduced Tony Tietze, the designer, with Wee Knife. And these are, I really dig this design with the compound grind. Very difficult to make in a symmetrical way, but we nailed it with this design. So I think these are pretty different than the final production varieties. Very beautiful. So if someone is interested, he can pick the color. This is the Fixed. I hope my sound is back. One of my cameras died, the battery died, so I don't have my camera available anymore. But I hope the sound is back again. Can someone let me know if the sound is back? The camera died, the battery died. Okay, that was it for now. If someone is interested in one of these prototypes, shoot me a message. My email address is in my bio on YouTube. You can also DM me on my Instagram account or on my Facebook account. So if you have any questions left, let me know. I think that was it for now. I hope you enjoyed it. Please remember to subscribe if you didn't subscribe already. Please like this video if you liked it. I hope to see you next week on Tuesday, 8 p.m. sharp. That's it for now. Bye-bye.